Good morning, class. My name is Ms. Parker, and today I will be teaching you all about how to write an effective paragraph using the Berger method. So, first off, let's just talk about what our objectives are for the day. So, our first objective is to identify the five main parts of an effective paragraph, and then our second objective is to write an effective paragraph, which we will be doing at the end of class today. So, first off, I just want to start by seeing what you all know so far about writing a paragraph. So would anybody like to tell me what they think a good paragraph begins with? Chelsea?
A topic sentence.
A topic sentence, that's great. That is what an effective paragraph begins with. Now, in between, there are some things that will be in the paragraph, but let's skip to the end and see what we think will end off a good paragraph. David?
Would it be a closing paragraph?
A closing sentence, yes, definitely would end the paragraph off correctly. So we're going to get into what the Berger method is for effective paragraphs. So we want to start off our Berger with a top bun, of course. And our top bun will be what Chelsea said with our topic sentence. So your topic sentence is basically going to tell the reader what the paragraph will be about, and it's going to just introduce the topic to the reader. So next we'll have our lettuce, which will be our first detail in our paragraph. And then after that, we move on to our tomato, which will be our second detail. Finally, we'll have our patty. And our patty is going to be our last detail of the paragraph, but we want to make sure that the patty and the last detail is the most important detail in our effective paragraph. And finally, we're going to end with the bottom bun, which David said was our closing sentence. Now, with this, you will be able to add more details. So if you wanted to add more toppings to your burger, you can add more details, and you'll just have a lengthier paragraph, but you want to try not to get too lengthy. So a safe number is to say not to go over 7 sentences in our paragraph. And also, we want to remember that our first sentence in our paragraph, so our topic sentence, must be indented at the beginning. And also, you want to try and not to use the same words to start off your sentences in the paragraph. So I'm going to read a paragraph to you, an effective paragraph, and I just want you all to listen carefully to how it fits into the Berger method. So it says, a lion is a very strong animal. Their roars can be heard as far as 5 miles. These carnivores have great sense of smell and amazing hearing. Lions can leap as far as 30 feet. These animals hunt very large animals and can only survive off of meat and water. The kings of the jungle deserve that title wholeheartedly because of their abilities. So with that, you can hear how a lion is a very strong animal is our topic sentence. And we end off, in the middle we have our 3 details, and we end with a very strong closing sentence that refers back to our first sentence. And you also see that it doesn't start with the same word a lot, so you could say a lion, a lion, a lion, but instead we do a lion, these carnivores, lions, these animals, and the kings of the jungle. So that's just an example of what an effective paragraph looks like, and then we're going to keep that in mind when we move on to our last, the end of class when we write our home paragraphs. Okay, so now we're going to do a chant to repeat after me when I say it, okay? Top bun, step 1. Your topic sentence is done. Top bun, step 1. Your topic sentence is done. Lettuce is step 2. Add a detailed sentence that fits your view.
Lettuce is step 2.
Add a detailed sentence that fits your view. Step 3 is tomato. Add more details so your knowledge will show.
Step 3 is tomato.
Add more details so your knowledge will show. Patty is step 4. It can be the last detail or you can add some more. Patty is step 4. It can be the last detail or you can add some more. Let's end it off with a bottom bun. Your paragraph's complete. That was super fun. Let's end it off with a bottom bun. Your paragraph's complete. That was super fun. Great job, guys. So now take out your pens and paper, and we're going to work on writing our own paragraphs, and I'll come around to help you all out.